Welcome to this virtual chapel meeting of the Andrew Murray Center for Spirituality. And welcome to this season of ordinary time in which we focus on God's liberating and healing presence in our fragile world. Imagine yourself in a quiet and comfortable place while you take a moment to become aware of your breathing. Inhale and exhale deeply a few times and welcome the Spirit, the life-giving breath of God, in every corner of your mind and body. In the light of Moses' encounter with God in the desert, our theme for the week is I am who I am. The suggested lectionary reading from the Gospels for this week is Matthew 16 verses 21 to 28. It follows directly after the episode where Jesus confronts his disciples with the question, "Who do you say that I am?" It all takes place in the environment of Caesarea Philippi, which by its very name reminds of the Roman Empire that controlled Palestine and surrounding areas. Even though Peter responded by saying, "You are the Messiah, Son of the living God," Jesus sternly ordered them not to tell anyone that he was the Messiah, probably because they still had much to learn about him. Let's read Matthew 16, verses 21 to 26. From that time on, Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and undergo great suffering at the hand of the elders and chief priests and scribes, and be killed, and on the third day be raised. And Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him, saying, "God forbid it, Lord, this must never happen to you." But Jesus turned and said to Peter, "Get behind me, Satan. You are a stumbling block to me, for you are setting your mind not on divine things, but on human things." Then Jesus told his disciples, "If any want to become my followers, let them deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For those who want to save their life will lose it, and those who lose their life for my sake will find it. For what will it profit them if they gain the whole world but forfeit their life? Or what will they give in return for their life?" Let's allow ourselves a moment to relive the drama of this incident. Imagine Jesus, after many conversations, teachings, and miracles in the presence of his disciples, asking them about their understanding of him. He has reason to be disappointed in their response, yet immediately starts to teach them about the kind of Messiah he was called to be, and that they would only be worthy of being his followers if they too were prepared to carry his cross, to be associated with his wounds. Alas, no thrones and crowns, but sharing in his suffering would be their highest goal. Shall we pray? Gracious God, how easily do we deceive ourselves by thinking that we understand who you are. Save us from ourselves, from our self-centered agendas, our limited perspectives. Forgive us in Jesus' name for underestimating you, for not allowing you to be who you are and to do your will unto us. dear friend, God bless you and keep you today. God graciously reveal God's presence to you right there where you are. God lift up God's countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.